The information contained in this book is intended to be educational and not for diagnosis, prescription, or treatment of any health disorder whatsoever. It is intended to provide helpful and informative material on the subjects addressed in the publication. It is sold with the understanding that the author and publisher are not engaged in rendering medical, health, or any other kind of personal professional services in the book. The reader should consult his or her medical, health, or other competent professional before adopting any of the suggestions in this book or drawing inferences from it. The author and publisher specifically disclaim all responsibility for any liability, loss, or risk, personal or otherwise, which is incurred as a consequence, directly or indirectly, of the use and application of any of the contents of this book. Simon & Schuster Audio presents Heal. Discover your unlimited potential and awaken the powerful healer within. By Kelly Noonan Gores. Foreword by Dr. Joe Dispenza. Read by Kelly Noonan Gores with Travis Tun. With audio from the award-winning documentary.
Foreword. What an amazing time to be alive. Since the turn of the millennium, more than at any other time in human history, information has become increasingly and more readily available. We are living in a brave new world. As a consequence of this great age of information, to remain ignorant is a choice. With the advent of technology, we are being exponentially empowered in countless new ways every day. Having information at our fingertips affords us the ability to make new, different, and better choices. No longer do we need a teacher or a formal education to access information that was once only in the hands of authorities, experts, and gatekeepers. By the same means, people all over the world are more motivated than ever to proactively research their own diagnosis and then make significant corresponding lifestyle changes. Millions of people are now seeking alternative treatments for their health conditions without consulting a doctor or blindly taking medication, and they are experiencing considerable results. Still others, without the aid of a priest, minister, or a rabbi, are taking the time to delve deeply into well-researched understandings about ancient religions, theology, and the nature of reality. Through these inquiries, they are having profound mystical experiences that positively alter them for the rest of their lives. When you gain information, the understanding of new knowledge creates a greater sense of awareness about yourself and the world around you. It lifts you above the mundane, routine way in which you see reality. A new awareness about some thing creates a new level of consciousness. And when there is a change in consciousness, there is a change in energy. The outcome is that you are empowered and awakened by knowledge. Why? Because knowledge is, has always been, and will always be, power. Thus, when you learn about yourself, you empower yourself. In a sense, you reclaim your power by no longer believing you are a helpless victim, one who blindly accepts having no ability or authority to change one's life. Gaining knowledge can cause you to cease unconsciously giving your power away to or relying on someone or something to do things for you. This is why the age of information is making way for a new era of consciousness. From a neuroscientific standpoint, learning is making new synaptic connections. Every time you learn something new, your brain assembles thousands of new circuits, which are reflected as patterns in your gray matter. The latest brain science research demonstrates that when you focus your attention for 1 hour on a concept or idea, the number of connections in your brain literally doubles. These new footprints of consciousness are the physical evidence that you learned through interacting with your environment. However, the same research shows that if you don't repeatedly think about what you've learned or take the time to review the new information over and over again, those circuits will prune apart within hours or days. If learning is making new synaptic connections, then remembering is maintaining or sustaining those new connections. With just a little concentration and repetition, intellectual information becomes embossed in your biology. This is how knowledge changes you. We don't see things the way they are. We see things the way we are. A different lens of how you perceive the world is inserted into your brain, and as a side effect, you see new possibilities, possibilities you were unaware of prior to your interaction with knowledge. That's because your brain only sees equal to how it's wired, which implies that you can only see what you know. While people do their best with what they know is available, if they don't know about something, we could say that it doesn't exist for them. In the same way, we could say that once they become aware or conscious of it, it comes into existence. In this manner, however, the acquisition of such knowledge is void of experience. When you can see a new potential reality or possibility, it's time to do something with that knowledge. What all of this comes down to is that the more you know what you're doing and why, the how to do it gets easier. That's why this is a time in history when it's not enough to simply know. It's a time to know how. As a seeker of truth, knowledge, wisdom, and information, your next job is to initiate that knowledge by applying, personalizing, or demonstrating what you philosophically and theoretically learned. This means that you're going to have to make new and different choices that will require you to get your body involved. When you can align your behaviors with your intentions, your actions equal to your thoughts, get your mind and body working together, you are going to have a new experience. Experience enriches the synaptic connections in your brain. When you embrace a novel experience, the new event adds to and enhances the intellectual circuitry in your brain. The moment those circuits further organize into new networks, the brain makes a corresponding chemical. We call this chemical a feeling or an emotion. The instant you feel more vitality, better health, wholeness, or joy from that novel event, you're teaching your body chemically to understand what your mind has understood intellectually. Now new information is making its way to your body, not just to your mind. And it's changing your state of being. In truth, you are conditioning your body to a new mind. And in that moment, mind and body are aligned to new information. It's fair to say, then, that knowledge is for the mind and experience is for the body. Now you are beginning to embody the truth of that philosophy. In doing so, you're rewriting your biological program and signaling new genes in new ways, because new information is coming from the environment. As we know from epigenetics, if the environment signals genes and the end product of an experience in the environment is an emotion, you are literally signaling genes in new ways. And since all genes make proteins, and proteins are responsible for the structure and function of your body, the expression of proteins is the expression of life, you are literally changing your genetic destiny. This suggests that it's quite possible that your body can be healed in an instant. Accordingly, if you can create an experience once, you should be able to do it again. When you keep making the same choices and reproducing the same experiences over and over again, eventually you will neurochemically condition your mind and body to begin to work as one. When you've done something so many times that the body knows how to do it as well as the mind, it becomes automatic, natural, and effortless. Simply said, now it has become a skill, a habit, or a way of life. Once you've achieved that level of competence, you no longer have to consciously think about performing that task. That's when you've truly changed your state of being, because the information is innate in you. You're beginning to master that philosophy. You have become that knowledge. The outcome of your repeated efforts will not only change who you are, but it also should create even more possibilities in your life that are a reflection of your efforts. Why else would you do it? And what do I mean when I say possibilities? I'm talking about healing from diseases or imbalances of both the body and the mind. I'm talking about creating a better life for yourself by no longer making the same unconscious choices programmed from past traumas. When you eliminate those choices, behaviors, and experiences, and you live by new choices, behaviors, and experiences, the results can come in the form of new jobs, new relationships, new opportunities, and new life adventures. This book and the Heal documentary are part of a new and different genre of journalism that comprises so much more than just a group of scientists, researchers, or healers espousing theories about how you can change your health. Because you can witness real people, just like you, experimenting with different modalities that might actually change their health, Heal is a practical and real study of healing. These stories of personal change and transformation are not Hollywood versions of glamorous triumph against all odds stories. Instead, in order to make significant strides in their recovery, these are accounts of common people who have had to look deeply into themselves to see what it was they needed to continually change in their thoughts, feelings, and deeds. These accounts are real and relatable. When I was first approached by Kelly Noonan Gores to be a part of the Heal documentary, I was overjoyed to know that someone was taking on a whole new level of investigation into what it takes to heal from chronic health conditions. I was relieved to know that her work provides evidence, which is the next level of information. Evidence is the most important voice. Someone had to tell this story, and I am overjoyed that Kelly took it on with such sincerity, clarity, and open-mindedness. What it demonstrates is that it is possible that the mind can heal the body. In fact, my research team and I have conducted several experiments to show that most healings begin in the mind. We now know that there is never a time when your mind is not influencing your body, and there is never a moment when your body is not influencing your mind. This means that in order to change your body, you have to change your mind, and vice versa. Consider the idea that in order to begin your healing journey, you must first become aware of what you're thinking about, and then literally change your thoughts and feelings. The long-term effects of stress hormones can push genetic buttons and create disease. Stress is when brain and body are knocked out of homeostasis, and it's the body's stress response that innately returns the body to balance. To live in stress is to live in a constant state of emergency and survival. Living in emergency mode for extended.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.